Thinking of a man, the only thing that's left to say. What a shame, baby, what a shame. Could have been with me instead of what's her fucking name. What a shame, baby, what a shame.
Listen, I know being straight isn't a choice and all, but settling is. Let me tell you about how lesbians work. Okay, Grace is on her way, and I just, you know, put a new towel for her, new towel for me, new hair towel. I'm about to clean the sink. I'm about to swifter the floor. I put, you know, my nice little diffuser, some smells going. Gonna light this candle. I'm gonna clean this floor. You know, she asked me for, you know, she goes baby, I'm gonna be hungry when I get that. That's all you gotta say. I said, what do you want? Tuna sandwich. Okay, you want tuna sandwich? I'm gonna make her tuna sandwich when she gets here. It's gonna be ready. I'm gonna go clean the kitchen. I'm gonna put chips on her plate. She wants chips. She wants onion dip. I'm gonna get that all ready. When she gets here, she's gonna have a meal. She's gonna have a clean bathroom. You think she gives a shit whether or not I'm swiftering the floor? No. You think she cares whether or not I take this little stain off the sink? No. But am I gonna do it? Yes, because she's gonna get the best care ever. Made my bed fresh for her. Got her a fresh towel. I'm sorry. I know y'all's boyfriends probably don't even clean the shit in their underwear. Never mind cleaning their goddamn toilet.
I recently kissed someone and they told me that they could tell that I kiss women because of the way that I kiss. There's actually so much more value than that in seeing women. Hear me out. Just listen. Just wait. Dating now has completely changed for me. Like, I will never see men the same because I have played that role now. I now know how fucking easy it is to just go pick up some flowers when you're grocery shopping. I will never accept less than being taken out, shown off, little things. Like, everything that, like, I want, I have done for a person now, and now I know how fucking easy it is. Like, and also, aside from like your standards for yourself being raised, I've also learned like a whole new sense of respect in relationships, because women are like such like delicate little flowers, and you want to treat them with the utmost respect. And now I actually like respect men a lot more, because I've like, I understand how, if you have a partner, how much that person deserves to be fully respected and treated with gentleness. And I know that sounds fucked up, like, oh, I didn't respect my like male partners in the past, but like, it's not that I didn't respect them, but it's that I've been fucked over by men so many times that my outlook towards like, unconsciously, unknowingly, I respected men less. And now like, I've just learned so much about, yeah, anyways, go kiss women.
I curve Tiffany, yeah, for Jess. Need to get myself together, I'm a mess.
I mean, I don't know. Are we secure enough in our marriage to tell this story?
Well, we have it in the laugh journal, so I think we're good.
Okay.
Yeah. We can laugh about it now. It was not very funny for, maybe 3 or 4 years after it happened.
This is the worst fight we've ever been in as a couple. So, and it was over a peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
So we're on our way to North Carolina from Tulsa. And we're gonna drive through, and we have the dogs, and so we don't want to lose time stopping, walking the dogs. So we pack everything. We pack the lunch, we pack their food, we've got water. Of course, we will have to stop for gas. And so I made the peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, had them all in the Ziploc
bags.
And Tracy says, she has examined the peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. And she says, now tell me this. Why did you put so little peanut butter on my sandwich. I said, what? Well, I want to know, why did you put, there's hardly any peanut butter on my sandwich. And I said, I made the peanut butter and jelly sandwich just like I always make it. No.
No, you did. No, you actually did make it just like you always make it.
Well, I guess she thought that maybe I was insinuating she needed to lose weight. Or maybe, you know, it was a calorie-cutting problem. Well, anyway, no, just listen, go ahead.
Listen,
you just go ahead.
You have to put peanut butter on both sides of the bread.
I never
and
have.
And then you put the jelly in the middle. Because if you, on a trip, if you put the jelly up against the bread, it will soak in and it will ruin the peanut butter and jelly sandwich. So you
put
peanut
butter. I didn't know there was that rule. I did not know it.
But we talked about it the last time we did the peanut butter. Anyway, that was the least emotion we've had in that story. Good job.
Well, we drove for miles and we weren't speaking to each other because she was upset about the lack of peanut butter, and I was upset because I was being challenged about the peanut butter and jelly sandwich that I thought was just delicious.
Listen, it was the best one I've ever had. No, and I was so grateful that you made it. So thank you again.
Wasn't really about the sandwich at all, was it?
No.
No.
But thank you.
You're welcome.
You'll smile at everything I say. You got some soft lips and some pearly white. I wanna touch them in.
Tú eres la tristeza y de mis ojos.
Yo, I'll solve it. Check out the hook when my DJ revolves it.
Because I'm both gay and ridiculous, I've come up with an entire encyclopedia of terms to describe the different lesbians that I've encountered in my life. Starting in alphabetical order, we have the auntie lesbian. Auntie lesbians are lesbians that are like 45 to 50 plus, the Deborahs of the community. Auntie lesbians are wise and mature, and the butch ones still be dressing like it's 2003, but that's okay. Next, we have the baby lesbian. We were all baby lesbians at some point. If you were a baby mask lesbian, then you probably played basketball throughout high school and middle school, and you loved you a good Bermuda. And if you were a baby femme lesbian, then all of your boy crushes was real pretty in the face like Romeo or Lil Fizz. Yeah, that's because they look like studs, sis. Next, we have the Bert and Ernie lesbian. Bert and Ernie lesbians are lesbians that have a girlfriend but are still in the closet. So they tell everybody that their girlfriend is their roommate. B and E lesbians and auntie lesbians are often one and the same. You know that one auntie that's been bringing the same roommate to Thanksgiving for like 20 years? Yeah, the one that looked like this? They fucking. And finally, we're going to jump to the L's for the leftover lesbian. Leftover lesbians are lesbians who are friends with literally every ex they've ever had, even the toxic ones. From the one they wrote shitty poetry about in college, to the one that cheated on them with 12 men, 10 women, a lizard, ran up fraudulent charges on their credit card, and broke their grandmama kneecaps. Is this giving series or no? Let me know in the comments.
She's a beast. I call her karma. She eats your heart out like Jeffrey Dahmer. Be careful, try not to lead her on. Shawty heart is on steroids, cause her love is so strong.
I'm gonna show y'all a couple of things that my wife just absolutely had to have. Number one is this milk jug of a cup, okay? I don't know why she needs that much water. Number two is this camera, all right? I don't know if y'all have seen these $1,500 iPhones that we all have in our hands, but they take pretty damn good photos. Number three is this Saint Laurent bag, all right? Now she says she needs a brown one because the black one doesn't go with everything. By the way, this is my engagement ring, okay? It was $10. Number 87 is this coffee maker right here. Even though she makes me take her through Starbucks once a day. Last but not least, we have a life jacket for my dog, who's never even been around a puddle before. We don't have a pool. We don't live near a body of water. The dog is scared of its own shadow, but by God, we got a life jacket for him.
I am not trying to seduce you. Would you like me to seduce you?
Are we taking this gorgeous girl out for her birthday?
Is there a special girl?
You are a special girl. You are almost girlfriend.
She's almost a girlfriend.
Oh, wife.
I'm coming back for you, baby.
I am not trying to seduce you. Would you like me to seduce you?
Bit of a girl crush. I'll stay on my side of the
cake. No, don't. I bring it on. My husband shares.
How many gay stylists did it take to put you together tonight?
One.
One gay?
Actually, no. I put myself together tonight, and then the
but
gay
you're
stylist
a
was the
person.
Hair.
Okay, good. So they gotta come in and at least finish it off.
Yeah, yeah.
Hard hair and makeup.
Let's get
but
down.
We play lesbian lovers, and we had a great time researching. I don't know if I have bisexual feelings, but I find it fascinating.
You do?
So, yeah.
You would like a guy.
The women danced for me. I was the only woman in there.
How to do that?
We went to lesbian bars downtown together at night and drank.
You did. And were you afraid that would get in the newspaper?
We were hoping.
We didn't care.
We were
nobody
hoping.
Even cared.
I was hoping, frankly.
Lesbians came up to me and they all went, we knew Hathaway was gay.
Are you?
Yeah, kind of. I mean,
she's the more dykey one, definitely.
Yeah.
He's the more
so
butch one.
Joe, are you the
I'm
husband?
More masculine.
All right, so
I
you
thought
took
you were
the lead.
Trying to do that.
Did you? Were you the one who led when you danced?
Yeah. But first, I got shy at first, and you were like, come on, let's go in. And I was a little nervous.
Speaking of her sexuality, you said you didn't hesitate to play a gay character. And that has sparked conversation in the LGBTQ+ community, saying, well, actors and actresses in that community can better portray a character like her. What is your response to that?
Well, I can understand that. My response also would be we're all making assumptions as to who I am. And what my past is.
What did he say?
And who's to say I haven't had my own gay experiences? Like, you know, we're making assumptions then.
That's
So
that's a really good point.
Which character you've played do you relate to the most?
Oh. That's tough. It's tough because that's tough to answer because Laura Peterson, who I just played on the morning show, is a character for some reason I think I might relate to the most.
Well, she's kind of where you are now, right?
Yeah. That yeah, way. Right.
So maybe it's just right. Exactly. Smart. Of course. Thank you, Nina.
You need head?
Oh, wait.
I say you don't need nobody else. Feels like you don't got me, so you feel like you've been by yourself. I've been feeling kind of down myself. I've been going through it as well, girl.
I'm